If they are discrete masses, then simply I do m1 r1 square plus f2 r2 square. But if it is continuous mass, there are infinite such masses exist, small dm. So I can't do summation, I have to take help of integral now. Okay, understood? All of you understood, right? So now we are going to take up one by one different objects and we'll apply this formula of integral r square dm. Fine? Ready? Take it? Okay. First, write down ring. अब चुप हो जाओ गधो, क्या बात कर रहे हो? क्या हुआ? Focus here. So please write down ring of mass m and radius r. Correct. That was the correct question to ask. I can't just say find out moment of inertia of ring of mass m and r. You have to ask about which axis. Okay. So we are determining about the axis which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane like this. Okay. About this axis, what is the moment of inertia of this ring? Try doing it. Apply that formula r square dm integral. It is very easy, this one.
If perpendicular distance of all the masses
the moment of inertia is mr square. Now tell me, for hollow cylinder, about this axis, what is the moment of inertia? Mass m and radius r. What is the moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about the natural axis?
Mr square.
All the masses are at a distance of r only. Okay? And you can imagine as if it is made up of rings stacked over each other. Okay? So here also it is mr square. Is the moment of inertia of ring and hollow cylinder same? Assuming masses are equal, then only this m need not be equal to that m. Okay? Okay? So we have got the moment of inertia for the ring and for the hollow cylinder till now. Okay? Now please write down moment of inertia of the disc. Disc of mass m and radius r. About the axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane. That we have it. How do you analyze this? How your TM will be? TM will be ring. This axis, about this axis. So I'll just give you a hint. You need to assume a ring of radius is small r and width dr. Small r and the width dr. And your small r will change from 0 to capital R. Now you are basically integrating di to get I. Di is for the dm. How much is di for the ring? What is the moment of inertia? The mass of the ring, let's say dm. So r square dm. This is the moment of inertia of the thin ring. So you have to integrate in r square dm. So you have to write, now r is constant or not? When you integrate, small r is constant? No, it is variable. So now it will not be coming out of the integral. It will remain inside. So you have to write dm in terms of dr now. You can refer back to the center of mass thing we have done for the semi-disc. Similar way you have to do here as well. How you write dm in terms of dr? Refer back to the when we calculated the center of mass of the half disc. The way we have done there, how to write dm as dr, same way here as also you have to do. Area inside area of pi small r square is area inside that, inside that ring. I am asking you area of this strip. This strip.
Dr
into 2 pi r. You can take this strip and make a rectangle out of it. So length is 2 pi r, width is dr. So 2 pi r dr. Now do it.
Okay.
finds the moment of inertia of the disk about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular disk is mr square by 2. The way we have written dm in terms of dr, exactly same thing we have done when we calculated the center of mass of the semi disk. Okay, so you have chosen not to go back home and revisit the notes or solve problem. That is why you are facing difficulty, and this difficulty will continue if you don't do anything about it. Don't tell me that I was sitting in a chair doing some school work. This is not going to help you in any way. Okay, if you're not doing this, this will not improve. Isn't it very straightforward? This thing. Okay. And every time you deal with a disk like this, this is what you have to follow. Mass per unit area you have to find out, multiplied by the area of the strip, which is 2 pi r dr only. Same thing you have to do again and again whenever you get a scenario like this. Okay. And in class 12th, same mass could become charge. So you have to find charge per unit area into the area of the strip. It will be again total charge q divided by pi r square into 2 pi r dr will be dq, small charge in the strip. Okay. So you just need to learn once and then replicate it. But if you refuse to learn the once only, it will come and hit you hard in the exam. And you will not get zero, you will get negative. Minus 1, na? Minimum mass is minus 1, it's not zero. What?
Anyone got minus 180
kg? You have to go world record banana, kya? Fine. We'll take 2 minutes break.